In this video, I will be showing how to collect and analyze data from online bibliographies using NetMiner. If you have downloaded the program beforehand as written in the video's description, you can find the Biblio Data Collector under the extension menu. The Biblio Data Collector collects bibliography information from online and analyzes author networks and research trends. If you click Collect, a window for collecting online bibliography data will pop up. At this moment, you can collect data using either Springer or KCI. I will now collect bibliography information from Springer. You can search according to titles, keywords, and journals. In this video, I will be collecting data about social network analysis from three types of research papers through Springer. Select the search standard as journal, input a journal name, and click Insert to enter the query. If you want to add multiple standards, insert AND or ER in the query. I've entered the year and the maximum amount of collection and checked collect detailed data. Though selecting this may make the process longer, through this you can collect more information. Once the process is finished, the collected dataset is added on the left. If you double-click the dataset, you can check the title of the research paper, author, abstract, and keywords. If you click Import, you can not only collect data from online, but also import RIS files downloaded from Scopus and the Web of Science. I will now import files downloaded from the Web of Science in Scopus. If you double-click the dataset, you can check the imported data. Also, if you click Merge, you can merge all the collected data into one. Now let's preprocess the collected data. If you click preprocess, a window for data preprocessing will pop up. You can easily extract bibliography information from the text data like the title and abstract. And identifying if authors with the same name are the same person. When you double-click the preprocessed data, you can see the newly added author and word tabs. In the author tab, there is information extracted about the author, and in the word tab, there is information extracted about the title, abstract, and keywords. Now I will import data into NetMiner to analyze. If you click Import into NetMiner, you can import the collected data into NetMiner. When the import is finished, two new work files are created. One work file contains the network analysis based on the co-authors, and one work file contains the network analysis of the words used. Now I will analyze the contents of the research and the co-author network. If you run the menu Transform, Mode, Two-Mode Network, you can change the network between the authors and research papers to a network between the authors. I'm making a link between the authors that have worked on the same research paper. Once the process is finished, you can automatically add the new network between the authors. Now I will check to see which co-author is the center of this network. By using degree centrality, I can check which author has worked with the most people. I've sorted the data in the order of highest centrality. Now I will look at the network map of the co-authors. You can see the network is separated into many groups of co-author networks. Now I am going to check whether people with the same affiliation work together, or if people work together regardless of their affiliation. In order to check this, I will use an analysis method called assortativity. NetMiner's assortativity analysis only supports the analysis of continuous variables, so I used a separate plugin to analyze the categorical variables. You can download this plugin in the NetMiner homepage. Select the categorical attribute as affiliation and run the analysis. The result has been reported. Observed shows the calculated assortativity value, and expected shows the average assortativity value of the data when putting a fixed number of links and nodes and randomly creating links. If the assortativity value is high, in the case of the selected attribute, this shows that there is a possibility of there to be many links. In conclusion, from the collected data, we can see that people of the same affiliation tend to work together. Now I will analyze the research trends using the extracted words. The plugin that I've just run automatically analyzes and visualizes the topic. You can download this plugin on the NetMiner homepage. More detailed information is listed in the video's description. Using the topic modeling method, LDA, I will extract the minor topics. This plugin visualized the most frequently used words through a word cloud. Once the plugin stops running, the word groups will appear. The blue dot shows the topic, and the connected keywords help us understand what the topic is. On the bottom right side, you can see basic SNA terms like vertex, edge, and graph placed in one group. Below that, there is a group related to community detection and a group related to frequently used research purposes such as classification and prediction. When you open the topic proportion work file created from the plugin, you can check the results of the bibliographies that are categorized by topic. By looking at the bibliographies categorized by topics, you can tell the importance of the topics.